Hello everyone, and welcome back to Project Cars 2 Career Mode. Even though I could move to a higher tier, tier 4, Formula Renault, I decided to stay in Formula C tier 5 of open wheel progress path. This is because the first time I did Formula C, I went with US Championship and then World Championship. This time I want to go with, I want to complete Europe Championship or European Championship just to get the missing accolade. From what I can see, my camera is missing, or is it? Find out soon enough. There we go, the camera's in. So I already pick up a team and I started the championship because I wanted to see what races will be in the championship, dates. So I did some preparation in advance where I went through all those laps from those tracks, did a few laps on each, check what times I can expect, and then I set up a proper level difficulty for each racetrack. And then for Brno, what I came with up, there is up first is Brno, where the difficulty should be at around 40. Don't ask me why, but that's what I found out. So it's really low. I'm keeping the aggression at 70 because I found this is to be a good level for AI not to crash into me. The next one will be Donington, where I'm going to rise the difficulty to around 60, then Imola 63, and then, and I'm not sure if I'm going to pronounce it correctly, Oschersleben 100, and Le Mans Bugatti track also 100. We'll see how it goes. Of course, the weather can have an impact on that difficulty level, so I will start with practice for every single race. And then I will try to find if what I initially set up or what I initially found to be a good setup is correct. Forecast is fog. Track is super cold. That race takes happens on 26th of February. I just checked my notes. 26th of February, it's winter. That race is in the middle, well, maybe the end of the winter, but the 3 degrees track temperature, those tires will be cold as hell. There's no chance I'm going to warm them up.
Go, go, go!
I think this is oversight on behalf of the game developers. There is no chance we would have a race of a Formula car in Central or Eastern Europe in February, in a winter month. I would be surprised if it would start a week. And the fog won't help because there is literally no sun going through, so that's why the temperature of that racetrack is so low. When I was doing my test for that racetrack, I was doing the test at low cloud level. So I think the temperature I had was at around 9 degrees, and so now it's 3 degrees. It's a bit of ridiculous to race in Central slash Eastern Europe, whatever you, however you like to look at the map of Europe. That was a huge crash there into the tires in February. Even though it's an end of February, still, February, March are cold months. And obviously because of such a low temperatures, the ambient is 7 degrees, the brakes will be cold as well. AI is a bit slower on the first lap. I think they simulate warming up tires or something, though I don't think temperatures have any impact on AI. I think they only have impact on players. So yes, my tires are at the moment 40 degrees in front and 38 and 36 degrees at the rear. It's just like, it's just simply cold. There's no grip in those tires. Here we go. Medium speed corner, third gear. But the car shouldn't be sliding like that. A high aero racing car. I'm fighting for every single bit of grip, and the AI is just driving like it's a normal temperature, normal grip, warm up tires and stuff. Left-hand side is warming up a little bit quicker than the right-hand side, but differences are so small. The coldest tire is the right rear one, and it's still 42 degrees. I'm hoping for better weather conditions during the qualifications in the race, because if it's going to be the same, it will be super difficult. A bit faster in that second sector than the last time. And I think I caught up with them a little bit, though they're much faster in that first sector while I'm sliding a lot. The tire stems are a little bit better, but they're still cold. haven't improved my position, but I improved my time. My qualification, my times when I was testing to set up the difficulty were around 2 minutes 10 seconds in a bit better weather conditions. Now I did 2 minutes 12 seconds. Quite busy here, the racetrack. This is so annoying when it happens. That will be 2 minutes 11. The next one will be also invalidated. Okay, so that's enough of the invalid times, and let's try to okay, I'm going to move to qualification. Return to pit box, skip to end, continue to qualifying. And start.
Go, go, go!
Okay, the weather is better, 16 degrees Celsius at the moment.
Okay, mate, you know the drill. Let's build some heat into these tires.
Should be a bit better. Should be a bit easier to warm up these tires. We'll see. If we can keep the same during the race, that would be amazing. Wow, I was going really slowly. That was a damage to my car. So annoying. That AI was driving it really, really slowly. Didn't expect that. Looks like this is going to be a really difficult qualifying session if I'm going to continue like that. Exactly that, bum. Cześć, niedziel.
All we need is one clean, fast lap. Let's take the pole.
No. So the temperatures, the tire temps are rising a bit quicker than during the practice. But still very, very slowly. The tires are super cold, still around 40 degrees. I think I will need a few more laps to at least try to warm them up. I'm not sure if I'll be able to warm them up. A and the temperature is dropping. It was 16 degrees at the start of the session, it's 12 degrees track temp at the moment. So the conditions are deteriorating. Tires are still cold, brakes are still cold. The car is sliding a lot even though the aero is set to the maximum. 2 minutes 10 seconds, 0.5, that gives us pole position at the moment. I went too wide for the last corner, had a really bad entry to the last corner here, the right-hander. But I improved the time just a little bit, it doesn't matter because it is pole position.
We got that, we'll go.
Tires are still cold, nothing changed. Below 60 degrees mostly. I think AI is slower than during the practice session. I think I've saw times around 2 minutes 10 seconds and 0.3. and at the moment I have 2 minutes 10 seconds 0.477 and I'm first. But there's a chance they will still improve their times. There is potential for them. I may actually try to deliver that lap instead of going to pits, because so far it's improvement and it can give me a higher chance of securing that pole position. This should be better negotiation of that corner, and it is. And it may be 2 minutes 9 seconds. It is 2 minutes 9 seconds 9 and 0.9, 9 tenths of a second. Quite a big slider, but it doesn't matter anymore. This time I will be going to pits to park the car and wait for the conclusion of this session. And even though this is dry, or, you know, it's not raining, it's just quite cloudy, the conditions are really hard, because this is 26th of February, middle of the, well, maybe not middle of the, but still winter. The track is based in Central / Eastern Europe. And the temperature is 9 degrees ambient and 10 degrees track. The tires are cold, the car is sliding all over the place. That race will be difficult. Here we go, and we are back. Pitbox. Actually, the AI is super slow today. I don't know why that happened. Their times during practice were at 2 minutes 10 seconds, and when I was testing, they were around the same, 2 minutes 10 seconds. My expectation for my time were high 2 minutes 10 seconds when I was testing. Obviously the conditions changed, so my time was a bit better. But I may increase the difficulty a little bit for that race. My advantage at that stage is too big. They won't improve, so I'm going to skip to end. There was just 30 seconds left. I'm going to continue to race. Here I'm going to exit to increase the difficulty. So let's increase it to 544 maybe, and then just start the race. A lot will depend on the conditions during the race on the track. the temperatures. So it's 9 degrees track, 11 degrees ambient, medium cloud. I think the temperature will be declining. Well, nice race.
Two lengths behind. One length back. Right rear corner. Right side. Still right.
Wow, basically faster.
Still there. Still on your right. Clear now.
Okay, not a bad start, still first. I will again try to use the advantage of warm tires. They're warm because of the warming blankets used in this racing series, but the temperature will deteriorate, and in two laps probably I'll be driving on cold tires because of the very low ambient and track temperatures, 11 and 9 degrees Celsius. So I have to try to build some advantage now while I still have a good grip. So the right rear is already below 70 degrees, which means it's considered cold. The left rear and the front right are exactly at 70, and the front right already dropped below, so it's also considered cold now. I pulled a gap of 1.6 seconds. The first lap, that's not enough. Three tires are cold now, all the four. Front left, which is doing the most work on this track due to the track being a clockwise track and due to having some mid-speed corners and even fast corners, that left front will be the easiest to warm up, or maybe not warm up, but the easiest to keep the temperatures up on it. 72 degrees at the moment, 72 is just above what's considered a good working temperature for that racing tire. To 65 and 60 degrees. The coldest one is the opposite to the left front, so right rear tire, really, really cold. Seconds advantage, not bad, not bad. Brakes are cold, below 200 degrees, and in those cars I cannot do anything about this because I cannot change the cooling ducts opening, closing. Normally I would close them, keep the heat on those brake discs, but on those cars there's nothing I can do. 2 minutes 10 seconds, 0.2. That's second lap. all four tires are now cold, below 70 degrees Celsius. It will be harder and harder to drive this car now, and the gap at Bold is already dropping. I think I'm a bit faster than them in the second sector. Yes, so from 1.3 I went up to 1.5 in that second sector. So the second sector, I'm still inside the second sector, it hasn't finished yet. 2.3 at the moment. A bit slower than the last lap. So overall drop lap to lap. Much slower than my fastest lap, interesting. The car is sliding, the rear tires are 58 and 52 degrees, really slow. The front are 67 and 57. Super, super cold at the moment. Really hard to drive that car. The gap is 2.1 at the moment, 2.2, so I had a bit better exit of that last corner. And yes, I improved my time a little bit in the last sector. That's the hardest corner at the moment because it's so easy to lose control of the rear axle. The car really likes to slide here on these cold tires when entering that fast or medium speed right-hander.
Great
first sector, that's your best split time so far. It's around 2 seconds all the time, so the gap I pulled when I was on the swarm tires for a short period of time, of not even a full one lap, I'm kind of controlling it and keeping it at that level, 2 seconds. I'm losing a little bit in the first sector, then I'm gaining a little bit in the first part of the second sector. I upshifted too early to the third gear, so I have to downshift again to the second, but the gap is now 2.8, 2.9.
You're leading by 3 seconds, protect that gap.
3.2, it's a good gap at the moment.
Great job.
2 minutes, 9 seconds, 0.75, but he didn't say fastest lap of the race, which means at least one of the AI drivers was faster than that. I could actually check it on my dashboard, I think. No, this is the fastest lap of the race. Could have increased the difficulty even more. I didn't know I'm going to improve by a second to my test laps. I didn't expect that. But maybe not by a full second, but still significantly, around 0.7 seconds. And I set up AI to do time set around 2 minutes, 10 seconds and a half. They are also a bit slower than I expected, because during the test they were running a bit better times. But it's okay, I'll take that lesson from the first race and I'll apply it to the other 4 races. And if needed, I'll increase the difficulty there more. Second race is Donington, the GP version, so the extra chicane left, right, and hairpin, the downhill hairpin, and 4.4 seconds advantage. And the difficulty will rise overall in comparison to Brno, because that Brno testing showed that difficulty should be at around 40. It's 44 at the moment for that race. The starting difficulty for Donington will be at 60. That's what my test showed. But possibly if I further improve my times, because I'll do some extra laps during the practice, then I may increase it further to around 65, maybe even 70, we'll see.
That's your best first sector so far, nice one.
The AI is very uneven. 5 races in European Championship, 5 different tracks, Brno, Donington, Imola, really nice track. Austria 7, or whatever the correct pronunciation is for that racetrack. And the last one is, if only I could remember that. Bugatti, Le Mans Bugatti. And the difficulty, based on my testing down before the start of this European Championship season, will be rising, so 40, 60, 63, 100, 100. was quite a slider. I caught it, but I lost some time there for sure. Yeah, I dropped below 4 seconds advantage. It's back to 4 seconds. Three laps to go. Truck temperature actually increased by 1 degree from 9 to 10, but it didn't have a big impact on the tire temperature, which are still all four are cold. Only one above 60 degrees, all the others below 60, one even below 50. The gap to second stays at the same level of around 4 seconds. There are 2 laps to go, so as long as I can control that, that should be a win. Two laps to go, 4 seconds gap to the second. The car is sliding on those cold tires. Continuously fighting for grip. The drop of the tire's temperature, my lap times drop as well. But it's okay because it's going to be a final lap and I just need to control the gap. Still around 4 seconds and that's
last
the final
lap.
Lap.
Looking good for the win, just keep it clean and tidy.
last two corners. Second gear left-hander. And the third gear right-hander, which opens up to fourth gear. And it's finish. And a win. A cool down lap to park in the pit lane. And that was the first race of European Championship. Last lap I think was my fastest one, 2 minutes 9 seconds 552. Do a quick check on my dashboard. It was also the fastest lap of this race. Dashboard shows 5.9 second advantage. We'll see what the game will show once I park the car and we'll be able to see the final results. Still had 1.4 liters fuel left. At the moment it's 0.2, so just enough to get to the pit hopefully. 0.1.
The first race win of your career.
5.9, so the same what the dashboard showed. Cannot see, my teammate is on 9th place, so it should be 2 points. Let's see. And one extra point for fastest lap. Yeah, he got 2 points, 28 points overall for our team, but we are GFP, OBX has the same amount of points, so both drivers scored better. Continue. That was the first round of European Championship. The second round is at Donington Park GP. Cool, a few emails just to add a little bit of realism to the game. And Donington. Practice qualifying and a race. I'm going to increase the difficulty. According to my testings, that should be around 60 for that racetrack. March 7th, so still very cold month. That would be probably really cold on the track, similar to Brno. -20 degrees, actually it's not that cold. It's a reasonable temperature. I have to wait for my turn.
Go. Take it steady until the tyres and brakes are up to temperature.
He was right to keep this temperature in mind. Yeah, 40 degrees or below is not warm for those tires. White had to release that accelerator. Truck temperature is 20 degrees, so I guess that clouds are not blocking the sun, which warms up the tarmac, but the ambient is quite low. Whoa. Interesting. The ambient is just 11 degrees, which means that the brakes will be cold, no matter what. The car is still sliding, but the temperature is rising in the tires, so it should be better with every single lap. Earlier there to the right hander, blind right hander. car is all over the place at the moment. Too deep to the first part of the chicane. And I'm third at the moment. Slight improvement, could have been a bigger one, but it's a fastest time of that session so far. I'll have to increase the difficulty then. Oh, much slower than last time. So even though I was much slower in that first sector, I gained quite a lot in that second. I'm expecting to gain in the third one as well, because last lap I was slowed down by AI. And I was right, though I don't see by how much. Thank you. I look at the dashboard to check the difference in time, lap times. It was by 1/10 of a second. I have to slow down. To be honest, I think that's enough. 1:36. That's exactly what I had during the testing, though I had high 36 while it's low 36, though as you can see the AI was set for high 36. And they too slow in comparison to my lap time, so I'm going to return to pit box, I'm going to skip to end and continue to qualifying. But I'm going to exit it to increase the difficulty to bring that AI closer to that 1:36 low, maybe 35 high. We'll see, 70 for qualification. It's raining. It is raining. Pinch tires. Okay, those are the wets, and let's start. Let's see if I have those wets. Not turning. Okay, now it is. Yeah, okay. All four are wets.
Kill those tires on this outlap. We need some temperature in there.
Luckily just a light rain, so the conditions are not too bad. Driving towards that sun looks cool, but limits the visibility significantly.
Focus on this lap, mate. Let's make it count.
Hi, mate. How are you? Very well, thank you very much. Trying to enjoy some of this project car's career mode. Yeah, go for it. Hopefully I have an answer. Let me just answer that in a moment, because it's quite a long question and I have no way of reading it at the moment. Oh, I was braking too late. That puts me on 12, which is probably last. There's 22 drivers in this championship, I think, but I guess not every single AI driver completed lap. So I'm expecting to be last, so let's try to improve this time. So it's a bit faster than last time, by 1/10 of a second, more or less. Lower in that sector. Oh, there is a puddle there, a fresh one. I don't think it was there on the previous lap. That puts me to 5th, that's not bad. I think I can improve further. It was 1 minute 43.1. Okay, so it's further improvement by 7/10 of a second, that's quite a lot. I locked wheels here while braking, that costed me probably some time. Kevin McKenzie just set a new fastest lap. Another driver was faster, by a second faster this time, that's good. Setting fastest and faster lap. Okay, and I'm 6th with that lap, so they're improving by a lot. Even though I improved by 1.6 seconds, I have improved my position. I think the conditions are getting better. It's not raining anymore. And we can see a dry line slowly. Lower than last time. I'm 7th at the moment. 9. I improved a little bit again. Second with that time, 1 minute 39.9. I knew that it would happen. I cut too much. Dropping to 4th, but driving for a better time. That slide was too big, that won't be an improvement. And it wasn't. Cool, I think I'm going to keep that whatever position it is, 5th at the moment. It will make for a better race, I think, more interesting starting from the... maybe not from the middle of the pack, but kinda not first, still somewhere in the front. A big puddle there at the braking zone. Hopefully didn't do any harm to them. I'm dropped to 9th. So that's middle of the pack at the moment. 138.7 versus 139. I'm losing more than a second. That's going to be interesting, guys. Just 2 minutes left. Let me look at that question now. What setting is it to where you can change your field of view on the helmet, where you can see your helmet in front of you? Or, okay, I'll show you. So if you go to options, and then you go to camera, and then you set your camera first to the helmet camera through the change camera button while you are in the car. The field of view for the camera is this one, helmet camera, and it cannot go above 89. So 89 is the maximum. If you do 90, the helmet disappears, which you can see right now. So 89 is the maximum field of view for the helmet camera. Okay, let's skip to end. And let's continue to race. I'm curious what will be the conditions. It's overcast, so there's a chance of rain, I guess, but we're starting on dry. So I'm going to load the stick setup.
On the right side, one on the left. Easy, cars both sides. Watch your left. You're clear.
What was he doing? Braking so hard on straight. I barely slowed down.
One leg behind. One leg back. Half length behind. He's 2 lengths back. 1 length behind.
Oh, sorry. It's super cold truck and super cold tires. Because I sold this. Sliding, it's very slippery, zero grip.
Okay, you're clear. Right side. He's cleared you. Right side. Watch right. Got a car right. You're good. You're clear.
It's 8 degrees. Truck temperature. Conditions are horrible.
One on your right. All clear.
That was quite wide, but it was a good exit on the corner.
That's P6. Sweet move. For the guy behind us and try and make it pass. Think about defending.
Super slippery. Brewer is constantly sliding. Rear tires below 50 degrees. Four laps to go, sixth at the moment. Huge slide here. A good exit from that corner. Try to go on the outside right here. We'll see if I can do it.
Still there.
Yep.
You're
that
good.
Worked.
All clear.
P5. Track conditions are as bad as they were, still 8 degrees track temperature. Super cold as for as expected for March.
He's 2 lengths back. Half length back, watch your line.
And a huge slide again on the cold tires. Barely keeping that car on the track.
On your right rear, right side, on the back right corner, right side, on your right side. Okay, he's cleared you.
I think if I didn't slow down, that AI would crash into me. He was really committed.
Watch your right. You're all clear.
Nice.
Still time to pick off any stragglers. One more lap to go.
Can we get one more position to P4? It won't be a podium, but there will be some extra points if I can get that. Another huge slide and a big loss of time. They overtaking there. That means they're losing some time fighting there together.
You got one, 2 lengths back.
Another slide, this time on the third gear. I think they're too far in front to have any chance of attack. Aggressive. I need to leave him enough space, but I was a bit aggressive there. That caused some damage to my front aero, but it's P4. That's not too bad. From P 13th to P4. So very valuable points. Down lap, straight to the pit stop after this one. Here we go, end of the race, Donington. It was hard race, super cold conditions, 8 degrees track temperature, 9 degrees ambient. Tires were constantly cold. The warmest tire was 64 degrees, was front left, the coldest was 46. But here we are, 4th from 13th. And 12 points as a team. First as a team, 27 points. So that means my teammate was just in front of me on the third position. Good. Overall, I'm staying on first after 2 rounds. And as a team, we're staying on first. Good. Perfect. A short break and round 3. round three and Imola, famous Italian racetrack. Autodromo, Internazionale, Enzo, Dino, Ferrari, Imola. We're moving from 9th of March to 23rd of April, and we're increasing the difficulty, and this is based on my initial testing. So we're going from 60 to 63 for that track in these cars. So weather conditions may influence that. I was testing on the same date, but in light clouds. I'm not sure what weather I can expect here. So we'll start with practice. It's an anti-clockwise race circuit, so right tires will be staying warmer than left. So we're going to reduce the... we're actually going to keep it as it is. That should be okay. Okay, yes, this card, and let's drive. Oh, it's raining. Let's see how strong is the rain. Is it slicks or is it wet?
Go.
Oh, it's too wet for slicks. So I'm going to change the tires. It's much easier to ride using the controller than the buttons on the wheel. Wet. Here we go.
Go, go, go!
Pit limiter.
See how the car handles in these wet conditions. We can make some changes to make the car easier to drive.
I guess I should avoid those curbs in wet conditions. Quite slippery conditions. The truck is warm, 20 degrees, so at least that. going wide in those corners and trying to avoid those curves. Gears instead of one. I was too happy upshifting. All the AI drivers finished their flying lap, so I'm last at the moment. Let's see if I can improve that position. First, so I improved significantly. Going faster than last time. Closing to the sector 2. An exact 1 second to the dot, quicker than the last time. Well, I don't think there is any point trying to further improve the time. I'm already faster than all of the AI. Let's return to pitbox and see the difference. Exactly 1 second quicker in those conditions. I'm going to skip to the end and move to qualifying. We'll see what kind of conditions are awaiting us there. Rain, that's the forecast, but I don't think it's... Okay, it's still wet, I think. Okay. Let's try to go on wet. Ah, yeah, it's still raining. Couldn't see it from the garage. Well, as I was second quicker, I'm going to increase the difficulty. is it? 25. We have some nice graphical glitch. Going to stay or is it going to disappear? Oh, it's not disappearing. Try to restart station.
Go, go, go!
Still there. What's going on here? Session again. Five. Okay, looks better this time.
Go, go, go!
Whatever that graphical glitch was, it disappeared after the restart.
Get those tires working, let's see what you can do. Okay, let's build up the speed and get on it.
It's quite rainy. Should have stayed on the second gear in that left-hander. aquaplaning and couldn't do anything there. The car just went straight. Let's try again. Conditions are horrible now. At least it's not as cold as it was on the previous race. Seconds slower than the last time. It's not looking good. The second sector was obviously quicker now because I stayed within the track limits, but I think overall this lap will be worse than the previous one due to the first sector. This is where Hamilton went south during the Imola race in 2021. Still too slow. I'm still second in the qualification. Hopefully I can improve the time now. Still second. slippery. Second slower, too many mistakes. Okay, a big improvement in sector 2. The first puddles are already appearing on the racetrack, which only makes things harder. Pole position. I barely touched that curb and the car was already going sideways. Too wide.
Check confirm, we got that, we'll go.
Looking at my wheel display instead of on a track. Kilometers per hour, driving faster is risking a grid penalty, and as I have a pole position I don't want to change this in any way. Early 259 thousandths of a second. If the weather is going to stay like that, it's going to be a really interesting race. Let's skip to end. Let's move to race. Heavy cloud, but no rain. That changes a lot, because the difficulty changes with these conditions. Raining or not? Six. And just in case, This one will do. That's wet tires in case they need it. Yeah. Let's see what are the weather conditions.
Concentrate on the lights now. Right. Get a nice clean getaway and hold that pole.
Okay, staying in first. Laps in quite a good conditions, 28 degrees track temperature. Lost quite a lot of time in that last two corners, 0.6 seconds.
Great first lap, let's try and build a lead and bring this home.
Messed up that chicane. They're much faster in that sector, which is a bad news for me because they're going to have a much higher top speed in that long straight and.
Okay,
using my
we've got
slipstream.
Some pressure coming from behind. Start thinking about defense. He's two lengths behind you.
That was a huge mistake. But that should make for a better and more interesting race. Bloody hell. I was going the same line as he was going. Oh, this is going really nice in that last corner. Definitely faster in the second sector.
Nice one, that's the best second sector so far.
Yeah, I cannot keep that speed in the last corner. That's what I'm losing the most. And I have a second penalty. Maybe I am able to drive a bit faster.
That's your best final sector so far. Great driving.
so much faster in the last corner. That's the most important corner, and he's so much faster there.
That's good consistent pace, keep it up, we're on target here, keep it up. Okay, you're clear. Two lengths behind.
Did it. Good. Going so wide there without any warnings or anything.
One length back, half length behind. Okay, we've got some pressure from behind. Start thinking about defending your line.
I'm going to drive a different line so he cannot get the slipstream. Do anything about it now.
He's two lengths back. That's the best sector time of anyone so far. Great job. Keep it up.
A bit too early on that accelerator. A huge slide. I need to have more than a second advantage due to that penalty. I have 1.5 at the moment. Two more laps to go.
Just set your own personal best lap. Keep it up.
Much better than the last time, though the overall sector time is slower. good advantage of 2.8 seconds.
Stuff. That's the fastest second sector of anybody so far.
And the final lap. He's too far away for slipstream, and I have 2.3 seconds advantage.
Okay, mate, last lap. This is your last lap. Hold it together. Bring her home for the win. Your lead to 3 seconds. Good job. Keep pushing.
Staying within the track limits, that's the most important part at the moment. Don't need another penalty. Almost 4 seconds advantage. And it's a win. Even though the penalty will reduce 1 second, it's still 2.4 seconds advantage. And a victory lap, and straight to pit. That would be funny. That curb really surprised me this time. I was careful enough to avoid it during the race. But I guess I got too relaxed during the cooldown lap. That's a very long pit lane. I have to find my pit stop, I can see it now.
That's P1! That's the kind of job we're looking for. Great driving!
Here we go, where's my teammate? Ninth, so that's extra point as well. Last, the fastest lap, I guess. It looks like this. Yes, so it's 26 points, I think. Second as a team. Not bad. 66 points, 2 podiums, 2 wins. 1 fourth place. And as a team, leading with a really nice advantage. Very safe situation here. And not too bad here as well. Almost double the points. Well, that will be enough for today. 2 races, plus qualification, plus practice. Thank you all for watching. The video will go to archive and to YouTube, and I will see you next time.